Hey guys, it's Nishant. Welcome to my channel. Today's video will be all about CRUD operations in React. You know, that is create, read, update and delete that we perform on API calls. So let's get started. First of all, let's create our application. Like type npx create React app and then the app name, which is CRUD operations. Let the app download the packages and dependencies. Now, let us install Semantic UI React package in our project. It is an UI library that provides with React components like buttons, dividers, tables, and all. So, to install it, go to this website called reactsemanticui.com and then copy this npm install. Semantic UI React, Semantic UI CSS text. And now in our terminal, paste this npm install Semantic UI React, Semantic UI CSS. Let it install. Meanwhile, copy this import Semantic UI CSS from the site and import it into index.js file. Now you can see that our app is running, but we need to remove this boilerplate. So remove everything like headers, class name app, logo, everything from the app.css file, delete app.test.js, everything from index.css, delete logo.svg. Remove this web vitals and setup test.js, and from index remove this import and function. Now we have a blank canvas in which we are going to create the project. Let us add a heading of h3 which will be React CRUD operations. React CRUD operations. But we need to center this element first. So in our app.css, first give it a div of main class name, and in app.css main height auto display flex justify content center and align items center. Or you can give it a width of, sorry, height of 100 px vh to make it in the center. Now we need to create four components for respective operations. Like in the src folder, create a folder called components, and inside this folder create more other folders. First create, next read, update, delete. We also need Axios to manage the API calls for our operations. So let's install it. To install it, type npm I Axios. Now we need mock API to send our request. So go to this website called mockapi.io, sign in and create a project. Give it a name, in our case which will be React CRUD operations, and then click create. Open this and click this endpoint. click a new resource and then type a resource name like CRUD. Remove all this because we won't be needing these, just this ID, and click create. Now we have a API that can be used for our operations. Click this CRUD, and right now the API is empty. Let us start with create operation. So in the create folder, create a component called create.js. Type rfc2 generate a functional component. Make sure that the name of the function should be starting with capital letter. Write some text like create operation. Let's import it into our app.js file. So import create from components create. Call this inside our main div. But you can see it is not aligned properly. So let us do that. Wrap this header into a div. And also this create. In our app.css file, give this main a flex direction of row or column. Now we need a form to send data to our API. So go to this reactsemanticui.com and search form in the search bar. Copy this text or code and paste it inside create.js. This will create a component, form component. As you can see, we have first name, last name, and a checkbox. We don't need this checkbox, so remove this form field. Now we need to get data from these two input boxes. So for that, we need functional component and use state hooks. So copy this form tag and clear everything. Type rfc to generate functional component. Make it capital, paste it here, and then let's import this form and button from Semantic UI React. So form and button. Let's import the use state hook. Use state and create two states, one for first name and one for last name. So const first name, set first name, use state and empty string. Similarly, let's create another for last name. So just change first to last, and this set first name to last name. Now let's set the state. Let's give it the input of input name of first f name and this l name. Now let's set this first name and last name from the input to our variable first name. So on change, set first name e dot target dot value. Pass this e into this parameters. Similarly, for this last name, we will do the same. But this set first name will be set last name. Now let's console it into the log. Sorry, log into the console. So console dot log first name. console.log last name. Bring up the console. Clear this console. Type the first name and last name, and you can see you are getting the first name and last name. Now we need to send it to the API. So for that, let's create a function call on constant send data to API. It will be an add a function. So let's map the submit button to this function. So on click send data to API, copy it and paste it inside. Now we need Axios to send data to this mock API. So import Axios from Axios, copy this. Axios dot post this URL or endpoint, whatever you want to call it, paste it inside, followed by a comma and then a curly braces, and inside this curly braces we will be sending first name and last name. So if we enter the first name Nishant and last name Kumar and click submit, you can see it is coming here in the API. Now let's work on the read operation. So inside this read folder, create another file called read.js and make it functional component. Make this read functional capital and let's import a table. So from table in semantic UI, paste it and import it at the top. Say import table from semantic UI React. Let's call this into our main app.js. So import read from components. Read. Create another div, empty div, and paste this read inside this div. And now you can see our table is visible here. But we need to give it a margin of 20 pixels. So style margin top 20. Right now this table is static, so we need to make it dynamic. And so import Axios from Axios, also use effect hook. It will load our data when the component is mounted or started. So use effect. Create a use effect hook inside this. Use effect, clean this up and this remove this input array. Now we have an empty use effect hook. So copy this Axios and say axios.get. Copy this endpoint from this create function. Paste it inside. Then get data and then console dot log get data. Now if we enter the console and see that check this object, we will see our config dot our data, our headers and all the data we are getting from the API, but we only need this data. So say get data dot data, As you can see, we are getting three array objects which are coming from the API. Now we need to map this table. So let's create a useState hook. First import useState. And create a useState hook API data set API data useState empty string, sorry, empty array. Now let's copy this set API data and set get data dot data. Copy this get API data and we will map this table according to this API data. So remove this extra rows. This one also. And then we can say curly braces dot map data return and then copy this table row and paste it inside this return. Now copy this data and say data dot first name and data dot last name. And now you can see we are getting the data in the table from the API. We can also do something like data dot ID because we also have an ID. This one will be first name and this one will be the last name. Data dot last name. Now our read operation is complete. Now let's work on the delete and update operations. So we need two more fields for delete and update buttons that when clicked upon will route to that page. Say update and another one delete. Similarly here we need two buttons. And let's import this button from semantic UI. So import button and save it. And you can see we have two buttons for update and delete. Let's change the name to delete. Also we need to change the color. For update it will be green and for delete it will be red. So green color for this red. Now we need to install the React router to route to other pages. So in the terminal type npm I react router DOM. Now let's import a few things from the React router DOM package. So say import React router DOM. Browser router as router. Then route from React router DOM. Wrap this whole div inside this router. then let's create two routes. Route and one for delete. Now let's create the routes for update and delete. So first of all, import update from components update. Similarly, delete. So import delete from components delete. Then inside this update route, say component update. Inside this delete route, component delete. So if we go in the delete route, we will say delete, and if we go in the update route, we will say update. But we can also see these two operations also. So let's take care of them. Create two more routes for create and read. So let's say here create route and read. It will be read. Remove this create. And you can see we are right now on the update route, and we can see only update. If we go to delete route, we will see only delete, or create route, we will see only create. This form. Now we need to map these two buttons for their routes. So import link from React Router DOM and wrap these two buttons inside link. Link to update similarly, link to delete. Save it. Now if we click this update button, we should be on the update route. You can check here. And if we click this delete button, we should be on delete route. But problem here is we are getting the whole components, all the components on a single route. So to solve that, we need to make it exact components, exact routes, exact, and then exact here also. Exact. So when we click this update route, we should be on update, and click delete, we should be on delete. Now in order to update or delete the fields, we need their respective IDs. So let's get that. Assign this button an onclick event of set ID and pass it as a parameter data dot ID, which we are getting from the API. Let's create this function constant set ID console dot log ID, and this ID will be a parameter which we are getting from here. So check the console. If we click this one, we will get 1 as ID. Click 2, we will get 2 as ID. Click 3, we will get 3 as ID. Now let's set this ID into the local storage. So say local storage dot set item ID. Let's check the local storage now. Okay, if I click this first, we will get ID as 1. Click 2, we will get ID as 2, and so on. Now let's create the update form. For that we can copy this form field from create form also. So copy it and paste it inside this update component. Also copy this form and button, or just copy the whole component and paste it, just change the name update, and here the submit button to update. Now let's get the data from the local storage. So in the update.js file, import the use effect hook, and then here say use effect. Clean this up, remove this input from the array. Now we need to set the data as the first set first time. So set first name local storage dot get data first name, and then get item, and here set the value of the first input box to first name. Similarly do it for the last name. And the value last name. Now if we go back and click the second field, we will get Nishant and Nishant Kumar 2. Again this one Nishant and Nishant Kumar. Now that we have our first name and last name in this form fields, let's update the data. Create another useState hook called ID and then set ID. Use state and null. It will be a number, so it's null. And then set ID local storage dot get item ID. Now we need to send this ID to this URL or this API. So we can say like slash dollar curly braces and then ID, and change this post to put. Now if we change the name and last name, it will change on the API also. So let's test it. Click this update Nishant and Kumar, change it to sync, and then click update. And you can see the first name changes to sync, and also in our table it's Nishant Singh. Let's say we update this ID to Nishant and Kumar 2, click update, change this Kumar 2 to just Kumar, and click update. Go back and you will see it Kumar. Now let's jump into delete operation. So create a function called get data which will get the updated data after delete operation, and copy this access.get and paste it inside here. Now create another function for delete operation on delete. Copy this on delete and assign this delete button to this function. So say on click on delete. Pass this data.id to this function as parameters and receive it here. Now we need to call the axios.delete function. So axios.delete copy this endpoint, paste it here, and dot then wait, and then we need to pass it the id of the field. So dollar and curly braces then id, then type dot then day, sorry, then call this get data function which will fetch the updated data after deletion. So let's test it. Click delete on the first id, it will be deleted. Click delete on second id, deleted. Fifth id, deleted. Now that we have created all the four operations, let's improve our app a little bit. First of all, if we type a name and last name and click submit, we won't be getting redirected to this read page. So let's do that. First of all, import use history from React router, then say const, sorry, let history use history. Then we can use this history to route to our other pages. For example, we can say dot then history dot push read. So let's say we enter some name, Nishant and Kumar, and click submit. We are getting redirected to this read operations page. Similarly, we can do it for update. Click on update button, and let's say we are updating this Abhishek Bohra. So here import use history from React router, same as before, and let history equal to use history. Now we need to redirect when we update. So say then history dot push read. So when we update, we will be redirected to the read page. So say 2 and click update. We can see the name changes to 2. Click this Nishant Kumar and change it to Singh. Click update. It will be changed to Singh. So that was all about React read operations, which stands for create, read, update and delete. Now you can do these operations like a pro. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe and comment.